Hi, welcome to another video tutorial from Robojax. In this video we are going to do the test review of this 3 ampere step down voltage converter based on LM2596 chip by Texas Instrument. So this is the device. So the length of the module is 43.2 millimeter. Width of it is 21.2 millimeter, depth is 13.2 millimeter. The module weighs 12 gram, which is very good. You can use it in drones and other equipment that weight matters. This is the module. As you can see, we can read the name here, LM2596. That's it. That's the chip. So we have input here. This is the positive input and this is the ground or negative. I've just connected it to these clips to make it easy for this video. So this runs with a very minimum components. We have a potentiometer that we can change it. We have a diode here and then we have an inductor, two capacitors at the end, some supplementary components here, and this is the output. Voltage can be adjustable from 1.2 to 37 volts. The input is to this device is 30 volts and then the output is 5 volts. So let me adjust this and see how it responds. By the way, this is multi-turn potentiometer. When you receive this, you have to turn it maybe 10-15 turns before you can see the effect, because it's multi-turn. So don't give up and don't think it's damaged. So I'm going down. I want to see what is the minimum. So the minimum is 1.56, and as you can see, the LED, the output LED is also totally off because that needs 2.2 volts and higher, plus some resistors that they put. So let's see, with the 30 volts, what we can get. As you can see, the LED turned on. So that is a very bad design. This should have been connected to the input. So 4 volts, 5. By the way, this is very accurate, so you can have up to second digits correctly. Let me see if I can do 9 volts. So I set it at 9 volts, so that is possible. So I'm turning it right clockwise, will increase the voltage. So 10, 12, let me go faster. What is the maximum voltage that we can get? 29.5. So let's see, let's go for 20 volts and 24 volts. Let's go industrial voltage. So 24, we got 23.3, 0.7 volts difference. Maybe I have to turn this again. No, that's... You see, I'm turning it so many laps before I see the effect. Now it's... So at this point, yeah. So let me go for 12 volts. And then what we can get? So now I have to do multiple turns before I see that difference. My multimeter, this voltmeter needs some voltage, so 2.7 volts works. I don't have 40 volts to test it, but up to 30 it was fine. So this is a data sheet. As you can see, this is a switching power supply step down, 3 ampere, that's the rated value, and the voltage can go up to 40 volts. Input voltage with the output can get 37 volts. These are the 150 kilohertz fixed frequency, that's internal oscillator, which we are not concerned. So this chip is offered a 2-pin configuration. This is one type of configuration, TO2220, which has a 7-pin in both cases, but this has a little longer heatsink here, as you can see. But the one that is used here is TO263, which is shorter, which means this area that can dissipate heat is eliminated. So when this is small, there is more risk, but you will see that. So another important characteristic of this one is the standby current is 80 microampere, which is very nice. When you don't draw a current, it will draw very little. 80 microampere is very low considering with a current rating of 5 volts. So this is a typical configuration. There are some maximum supply voltage, 45 volts, so it can handle up to 45 volts at the input. And the lead temperature, the maximum junction temperature, 150 milliamp degrees Celsius, and then the vapor phase for 60 seconds, it can handle up to 215 degrees Celsius. Factor operating temperature from minus 40 to 125 degrees. We are adjusting it, it will be 73%. Here we have full details of the design and calculations. This is when you use it as adjustable. So here are the formula, which I'm not going to go through, but I would definitely suggest if you are interested to play or work with this chip, have a look at this. So have a look at this data sheet. The data sheet will be provided. So the link for the data sheet will be provided at the details of this video. Okay, now let's test it with 12 volts input and 9 volts output. Let me go for 3 amp. So now we have 3 amp. Very hot immediately. So that is 27 watts. Okay. So conclusion. So 12 volts input, 9 volts output, 3 amp. Not good. Died. Let me turn it on with 12 volts input, 9 output. This is the output, 9 volts and then 2 ampere. So the device is, the module is hot, but not that hot because I can put my finger here. So the module is hot, but this is not as hot as used to be with 3 amp. So counterclockwise will decrease the voltage, just pay attention here. So that is output 5 volts. So let me turn it on. I'm just pressing this button here. So the dissipation started 3 amp. So this load is now dissipating 3 amp from this device. So it's heating up. So 4.9 volts. So it will shut off now. Okay, so 3 amp doesn't work. 12 volts input, 5 output. 2.5 amp, let's see. By the way, it was already hot, so we just continue with the test. So when the temperature reaches above 45, this heat sink will turn on. Now I have to put this because the wind from this will just cool this off and will give us false result. So the device did not shut down, but I do not trust this 2.5 because this is extremely hot, and I would advise against it to get 2.5 amp from here at 12 input and 5 output. Okay, I've set this, now I'm testing it for 3.3 volts, so I've set this for 3 volts to shut off. Let's go for 3 amp. All these components are hot, all of them, because this board is hot, the heat is transferred because this is directly attached. All of these are at the maximum temperature at the moment. So it shut off. So 12 volts input, 3.3 output with 3 amp, no good, failed. Now I'm putting at 3.3 volts at 2 amp. So with 2 amp still it's hot. No, I can touch it, it's hot, I cannot hold it for a long time, but it's very cooler with comparing to the previous 2.5 and 3 amp. So 12 volts input, 3 output with 2 amp, that's good. So based on the test that I did, we came to conclusion that this device cannot handle 3 amp or 2.5 amp at all, at any voltage. So this can handle 2 ampere when the input and output voltage are very close. But if the voltage output and input are too far, for example, from 12 to 3 volts, 2 ampere will be too high because the dissipation of voltage will be too high and the temperature will increase. This will not be able to handle it. But generally, 2 ampere seems okay. So if you can have a fan or something that cool this off, it will definitely work 2.5 amp. But 3 amp, absolutely not. It needs bigger heatsink here. It needs actual aluminum or other means of good heatsink. So that's it, folks. Please thumb up the video, please share it, and also please subscribe so you get updates of my upcoming other reviews.